Well, this week we've been airing our special investigation highlighting Washington's mission to spread its version of democracy worldwide. In our first segment, we detailed what democracy promotion actually means, financing and political support to forces in line with Washington's agenda. In part two yesterday, we explained exactly how that works. Now it's time to follow the money and talk about how much money Washington has injected into these foreign countries. RT's Jehan Hafiz has the final report in this series.
Great party, but who's picking up the tab? Apparently you are, the American taxpayer. $9 billion spent by the United States Agency for International Development on promoting Washington's democracy initiatives. A new model for influencing a target country's internal politics in favor of U.S. interests through financing, training, support, and guidance to pro-U.S. forces in foreign countries. Another democracy promoter, the National Endowment for Democracy, received $132 million during 2009, nearly all of it from U.S. government agencies. But these are just the tip of the iceberg. There is an entire network of organizations involved in the democracy promotion business.
Now in its third decade of helping breathe the life of democracy and freedom into people without hope all across the world, the International Republican Institute stands upon.
Although all organizations insist there is no political affiliation, the board of directors for both NDI and IRI suggest otherwise. Former secretaries of state, national security advisors, members of Congress, and even Clinton, Bush, and Reagan administration officials. They all have a history in Washington, one deeply rooted in sustaining the current foreign policy priorities.
To understand U.S. foreign policy, one must first understand a very basic fact. The U.S. government wants to dominate the world.
This is what democracy promotion brought the people of Honduras. While USAID requests $800,000 for strengthening governance and democracy in Honduras, journalists and activists are being brutalized and killed under the U.S.-backed government. In Egypt, a revolt against the U.S.-backed policies of the Hosni Mubarak regime has mobilized these agencies to co-opt opposition groups, ensuring the result of the upcoming elections will be beneficial to Washington. Wail Nawara is a member of an Egyptian opposition party that received funding or support from many.
NDI, the IRI, the people like Carnegie, of course, POMID, the project of Middle East democracy, the NED, National Endowment for Democracy.
With information and support.
Many who study these agencies believe the soft money working behind the scenes is directly linked to the CIA.
They had to have this a new organization with a nice sounding name, democracy in it, a nice sounding name which would be free of the taint of the CIA. And that was the reason the NID was created.
USAID has implemented democracy promotion initiatives in over 100 countries in the past 25 years. This year's budget, $1 billion. According to USAID's website, spending $10 million in a target country increases its amount of democratic change fivefold.
How much of your tax money would you like to go to promoting democracy in Venezuela?
None. Not that much.
Would you be okay if foreign governments were giving our politicians money for the election campaign?
No, that would bother me.
And herein lies the hypocrisy.
We have a very clear law on the books prohibiting foreign governments from interfering in our elections, of supporting any candidates with money. So we do exactly abroad what we prohibit at home.
Encouraging transparency is a stated core element of the U.S. government's democracy promotion efforts in foreign countries. However, here at home, the agencies themselves are far from transparent. Detailed budget programs are unavailable to the public, and contact with the media is limited. Over the last 6 weeks, RT repeatedly requested interviews with USAID, NED, IRI, and NDI. All of our requests were either denied or unanswered. Jehan Hafiz, RT, Washington, D.C.